How are you?
Hello, Miss Pruitt. I'm doing very well.
You're doing good?
I am doing great. Thank you very much. Good to see you.
It's good to see you.
Charlie's here. I haven't seen him with a goatee.
Where anybody has attacked any member of your family. Now, we have put documented evidence on that where we suppose that you've got a sweetheart deal from the United Community Bank, and we have the documented evidence here.
There's no evidence there, Mr. Miles.
Yeah, and it's documented.
You know what interest rate I'm paying?
As you said before, if you were supposedly hiding it, you wouldn't have filed it.
It's all out there.
That's fine. We're not arguing that whatsoever. The document is good enough for us.
That's absolutely.
Do you have any statement to make in front of these folks about
sure.
the
Which
validity?
One do you want to start with?
This
Which
is
one?
Your this is your transfer of your private home
to my dad
to your dad into a corporation, and then you still I assume you still live in the house?
Of course, it's my
okay.
house.
It is your house.
Yes, it's my house.
Okay, but it's in a corporation's name.
It is.
And you own the corporation.
I'm a shareholder in the corporation. My dad's the other shareholder. We put it in there for estate planning purposes. My dad's wife died. I'm single.
Okay.
My kids, I'll put it in an LLC so that all of those assets
so all transferred. This all this transfer took place during the time that you were voting and discussing moving the county's money to the United Community Bank. Is that correct?
That would be wrong.
Am I wrong about that?
You're wrong.
Oh, I
because
am?
I recused myself from the voting as soon as this started. I went to our county attorney and told him what was going on. He advised that I recuse myself. Mr. Milam, it takes three people to pass something.
Right.
Not one, three.
Right.
I pay a higher interest rate than the street rate.
Okay. So none of us should have any problem with this transfer of your home and with anybody. This is totally legit, clean.
Absolutely.
FDIC will have a problem.
If I had a thing to hide, I would not have had it filed locally.
Thank you, sir.
The letter's right there from my attorney.
Yes.
It was sent to you. I think Ms. Mills got one.
Yeah.
Who else got one? Ms. Story got one.
Yes, and Ms. Tisdale.
Yeah, Ms. Tisdale. I'm a public official. I'm elected to serve the people of this county, and I'm glad to do so. But when people start dragging my son and things of that into it, yeah, I'm going to.
And one of us did that?
Yes, sir. I've got the screen captures. I've got this, all of it.
Would you like to tell these folks?
I would not have sent that.
Did I do that?
It was on your site. You were sent this because you were the administrator of my blog.
That you don't argue.
I'm not going to argue with him because he's wrong.
Did Ms. Mills, did she attack your son?
Mr. Milam, I will just tell you, okay, because you're sitting here, you're grandstanding.
No. I'm asking, I want to clarify in my own.
If you talk about my son, my daughter, my ex-wife is a very good friend of mine.
Yeah.
My dad, yeah, I'm going to sue you, okay? I'm going to sue.
That's what we've got four of us.
Now, if you.
Well, take it to court and leave it out of this room.
Exactly.
Really?
This is a community event.
Yes.
You don't question that. What I'm just publicly saying, you come on and ask, because if it's a public decision I've made, I'm as transparent and open as accessible as any person in this state, Mr. Milam.
You answered my question.
You've never called to verify anything that you've filed.
Who paid off your mortgage?
Yeah.
Who paid off your mortgage?
I pay it every month.
Who paid off the mortgage with the transfer?
There is none. The LLC has a mortgage on it. Thank you very much, which I pay every month.
You know what that is.
Why are you so worried about my estate planning, Terry?
Just ask a question.
What, I understand, but why are you so worried about my estate planning, Terry?
Because when you do banking in the county, and there's some sneaky stuff going on.
There's no
like
sneaky stuff.
A question. You know
there's
I mean?
No sneaky stuff.
Yeah.
It's all documented on the clerk's office. That's the reason it's there. It's because it's transparent.
And that methodology is very common for estate planning.
Yes.
It absolutely is.
If you don't I'm know about the estate planning, don't have a problem.
Nobody can bother your kids.
Thank you.
Yes. They're not a public official. You are.
You're absolutely right.
Let's change subjects.
Go ahead.
What is the county's position relative to electioneering signs on property all throughout the country? The elections, you know, they're on before the elections for months. They're on.
You talking about our signs?
Any signs, any political signs that are all over the property, all over the county, for extended periods of time, to the point that they utterly become trash.
Well, they do. And signs on private property, meaning if I came to you and asked you if I could put a sign in your yard, that's probably not what you're talking about.
I think I'm truck going down the road with 46 signs just sticking them everywhere.
If I have signs out there that are in the right of way,
yes.
They need to pull them, number one.
Yeah.
If they are there, you know, there are a lot of people that get involved in a project, and then if they win or lose, they forget about it, what you say.
Okay.
Well, I think it's legal. I don't agree with it at all. And if I'm a candidate, I need to be responsible to make sure my signs are up. What I did is I paid the Boy Scouts in this county $1 per sign for everyone they brought. And I'm going to tell you what, they went out there like gangbusters. There wasn't a sign left.
Okay. So how can we get everybody to do what you did?
We'll vote for people like me.
That's not enough.
Any other questions? I don't know that. I don't know that. Do we have ordinances against it? I guess we can take them. It's about the best we can do. I don't know any other answers. Hopefully people will be responsible and get their signs. Yes.
Patrick, I know that you recused yourself from this, and I'm not, it's nothing to do with this. It's just about United Community Bank, and it's just a concern. Because, I mean, I am a shareholder of United Community Bank as well, and I have sat and I have watched in the last 2.5 years them go from $38 a share.
62 cents.
No, today it was 7.06, I believe.
Oh, okay.
But in June, they had a reverse split, 5-1. Which takes five shares and puts it all in one to inflate the one share to make it to where they are not, to make it to where they're not below $2 to where they have market issues. We've taken, and we took on that contract with them. If it was a, I've been out of the loop a little bit. I don't know if there's a contract with them. But the concern is, and I realize that there is a municipality that would have to be insured from, because it is a state revenue issue at 110%. But what happens when we get to the point where it's reporting to the state, because the United Community just keeps falling. And it went, like I said, from $38, then they had a reverse split to go back to make it in June to where it looked so bad. Now we're down to $7.06. The COO retired in September, which is one from the old Roswell Bank that would have never, I couldn't imagine him retiring, you know? I mean, my concern is our capital money. You say that, but what happens when Habersham County is in there, Union County is in there, I think we've got five or six more municipalities that I found out about today. Okay, so wait a minute, let me talk, let me finish, okay? We've got all that. They report to the state board every month to make sure, to state revenue, and state revenue makes sure it keeps them in check. But what happens when that month that they actually have another loss, like they did this last quarter, who's gonna be left holding that? Because FDIC is not gonna pick up that 110%. It's not gonna come out of their, it's not gonna come out of their revenue or their capital either, because they're not gonna have it.
They had to purchase treasury notes equal to 110% of our deposit.
I understand that. But when you, as I was explaining to you today, okay, because it was a concern of mine, just because that's what keeps our bond rating. That's what keeps us there.
And is our money set.
And that's right. And they continue to lose. They may have had to purchase bonds, but what happens to that point when they start hitting that wall? Are y'all going to move out of the bank?
Well,
are you going to make that decision? Because we're about there.
You know, the bank contract's renewable every year, even though it's a long-term contract. It still has to be approved every year.
If we're not within that year, and it hits it every month.
I'm comfortable that our cash is safe, if that's what you're asking.
So when they get down to...
They can't touch the treasury bond.
When they get down...
Then we move.
And then, okay.
If they can't provide the services that we need and they're unsafe, then we move. I mean, there's no reason that, I know that people like to cook up these grand schemes.
No, that's not what this is about, and don't start.
No, but the reality is.
But I'm just asking the question, because it is a question, because that is all that the county has.
You're right, and I'm comfortable that it's safe.
And they are a very small bank.
But if there is any indication that it's not going to be safe, of course we're going to move. Of course we're going to move.
Are you aware of how much they've gone down since y'all went through that?
I get reports all the time. I get reports from Wells. I get them from United Community Bank. I get them from SunTrust. Now, do I study them and memorize them? No, but I do watch them. The other thing is there's a big concern about why did we go with a bank that's charging us $50,000 a year from a bank that was going to do it for free. Okay, that $50,000 number was incorrect in the beginning. It was 30 to 50. Okay, that was 30 to 50. They've already saved us 40 grand. Credit card cost. So we've made $10,000 so far over and above.
How did they save on the credit card cost? Is it from the percentage of the credit cards that the water takes in?
They charge us less than SunTrust would have charged, and they charge us less than Bank of America. So the net result is going to be not free, a profit to the county at the end of the year. And that report's being provided now because we've got some months behind us now to be able to look at that. We don't have a full year. But the fact of the matter is we're going to actually make more money than we would have with Bank of America, which was hosing us. And SunTrust with their free service. It wasn't free. You know, the facts will be there.
It's a question, and it's a very big concern.
I know you're concerned about it. I've seen it. And if you think that I'm willy-nilly not worried about it, yeah, I do watch it. Absolutely. But I'm one of five commissioners, and we all do that, and we have a finance committee, and we have staff, and we all...
I'm asking a question, and I know there's five, and please don't be that way, because I'm just asking a question out of concern, okay?
Well, it's safe.
Okay.
It's totally safe.
Patrick, you may have already answered this question, but is every dollar we have with United Community Bank FDIC insured?
No. It's not eligible for FDIC insurance because it's too great.
Okay, have you ever heard of CDARS?
have, no.
You have never heard of CDARS?
No.
Okay, CDARS is a program for municipalities or for an individual who just sold a business, say they sold a business for $20 million, or say the municipality has $200 million. CDARS, and I know SunTrust does sell CDARS. So does all the big banks do. But what it does, it splits that money up, and you don't have to do a thing. The bank does it for you to enough banks so that every penny is covered, FDIC insured. Now, why doesn't our county have that money in a bank or some institution that will have CDARS for them so that every penny we have will be FDIC insured?
Well, Mr. Ward,
Mark Howard talks about this all the time.
If the money's lost, you don't get an equestrian facility.
That's just the
way it is. I hope you want to protect that money for your horses.
There are many companies are protected, but there's nothing like FDIC.
You didn't get on one.
It's going to be good unless the federal government fails.
Well, yeah, I guess my question. Patrick, I guess my question led to. We saw the Integrity Bank crash. Everybody felt it. That's why we have a lot of these mothball subdivisions.
I'd say a lot of banks had problems.
Well, but I'm saying that is it.
I wouldn't say it's Integrity. I'd say it's a lot of banks.
Integrity, Bank of North Georgia, your big developer lender banks, United Community Bank, Community Bank and Trust. Those are the four biggest developer lending banks in Georgia. Okay? With that, they're the four most declining in stock prices and losses as well. Why did we not pick some, like a bigger bank that we actually could be safe with to not to have to sit and babysit?
We're totally safe with United Community Bank. Totally safe. 110% totally and unequivocally safe.
Did you find that out this morning?
I've known it all along.
Okay. I'm just asking the question.
I've known it all along. They had to capitalize everything we put in the bank. Every dollar we put in, they put $1.10 aside. And they have to. It doesn't.
Well, actually, they put $1.17, but that's, neither here nor there.
Totally safe. I have no problem. And I'd rather help the Georgia bank recover than I would any other bank out of the country. Mm-hmm. SunTrust is a pretty good bank, but
the point is, they're plummeting. So are we going to let Forsyth County go down with them?
We're not going anywhere.
Have you seen their Texas rating?
If they fail, we just move our money to another institution. Our money's safe.
But if they fail, you're saying we're safe, but if they fail.
If they fail, we're safe.
So
we're safe.
Is there something we can look up to find that information out? Just where would we go to find that?
We can go back and watch the work session and watch the presentations on what was done. You could go pull the banking contract. You could ask for a copy.
Where do we get the banking contract?
Call the finance department. Do an open records request and ask for a contract.
And it would give us the proof of what you're saying we're safe.
You'll see it in the contract. Okay. Do you think I was saying if it wasn't true?
Well,
come on now.
Frankly.
What bank are we talking about?
United Community.
United Community?
Yes.
Any other questions? Yes, sir.